Hello everybody, so today I will talk about chemistry. The topic today is chemical equation. And now I will show the technique how to answer the question. We have aluminum oxygen and aluminum oxide, or we can say aluminum three oxide. So because they don't have the balance in here, so we need to balance this one. We have, we put number 2 in here, so we have 2 multiplied with 3, you got about 6 oxygen, but in here we have 2 oxygen, so we need to put number 3. So 3 multiplied with 2 and 2 multiplied with 3. Next, we have 2 multiplied with 2, you got about 4, so this one should be about 4. Now, after we balance this equation, we put about number 4, 3, 2 in here. Then we go to the question. How many moles of aluminum and oxygen are needed to produce 10 moles of aluminum 3 oxide? So we put about number 10 moles in here. So the question, they ask about aluminum and oxygen. So, to find the mole of aluminum and oxygen, you put number 10 multiplied with 3, later that divide by 2, so you can get about the answer in here. So, we have 10 multiplied with number 3 divided by 2, and this is about 15 moles. Next, similar for aluminum. So we have 10 multiplied with number 4 divided by 2. So you got the answer in here. That should be about 10 multiplied with 4 divided by 2. You got about 20 moles. Question B. How many moles of aluminum oxide will be reduced if 25 moles of aluminum react in the stream of oxygen gas? So they just provide 25 moles of aluminum. So we put 25 in here. So they just ask about aluminum oxide. So we have 25, we go to number 2, then divide to number 4, and you will got the answer in here. This is about 25 multiplied with number 2 divided by 4. So you got about 12.5. moles. Next one. How many moles of oxygen we needed to react complete with 5 moles of aluminum? So they just provide 5 moles of aluminum, just 5 oxygen. So we put number 5 in here. So we have 5 multiplied with number 3 divided by 4, and you can get the answer in here. So that means we have 5 multiplied with 3 divided by 4. So that's about 3.75 moles. The next one, we have the molar mass. So the formula for this situation, that's about moles equals to mass divide the total atomic mass. So in here we have the mass is about 52, and we have total atomic mass, we have 2 oxygen, so we use 16 multiplied with number 2, and this is about 32 in here. 52 divided 32, you got about 1.625 moles. And in here, we put about this number in here. So they just add about aluminum. So we got about go to 4 divided by 3. So that's about 1.625 multiplied with 4 divided by 3. And you got about 2.167 moles. The next one, how many grams of aluminium oxide are produced if 2 moles of oxygen gas react with 3 moles of aluminium? So we have 3 and we have 2. Oh sorry, 2 in here. In here. Now we have 2 and 3, so we need to compare which one is the lowest mole if we use about 2 reactants in here. So we have 2, so we 2 go to 4 divided by 3. And we have 2.67. So because 2.67 more is smaller than number 3 in here, this means the oxygen is the lowest when we compare to the mole for the aluminum. Now, so we use number 2 to find the mole of this one. So we have 2 multiplied with number 2 divided by 3. And we can get the answer in here. That's about 2 multiplied with number 2 divided by 3. That's about 4 over 3 moles. And we have the formula. The mass equals to moles multiplied with total atomic mass. So the mole in here, we just got about 4 over 3 multiplied with, we have aluminium, so that is 26.98 multiplied with number 2 plus 16 multiplied with number 3. And we got about 135.95 grams. And the last one, how many grams of oxygen are needed to react with 10 grams of aluminum? So we just do the same one, we find the most. And we have the mass divide total atomic mass. So we have 10 divide to 26.95 and 98. So you got about 0.37 moles. So we just put in here. So we do the same one, multiply with number 3 divided by 4. And we got about 0.278 moles. So we can find the mass in here is about 0.278 multiplied with 16 multiplied with number 2. And you got about 8.896 grams. That's the end. Thank you for watching.